Welcome to the first video in this series where I want to help you understand DNS. DNS is one of the core services on the internet. When it doesn't work, applications and other services will fail. Now, in this video series, I'll be covering what DNS does, why it's structured the way that it is, how DNS works to get us answers to queries, and I'll finish up by covering some of its key limitations. Now, with that being said, let's jump in and get started. Now, before I cover how DNS works and why it works in the specific way that it does, I want you to be 100% sure of what functionality DNS provides. Now, when you access any website, you type the name into your browser, for example, www.netflix.com. Now, you might imagine that the name is used to connect to the Netflix.com servers and stream your movie or TV show, but that's not actually how it or any internet app generally works. Simply put, humans like names because they're easy to remember, but networks or servers not so much. To communicate with Netflix, your computer and any networking in between needs the IP addresses of the Netflix servers. DNS actually does many different things, but at its core, it's like a big contact database. In this context, it links names to IP addresses. So using DNS when accessing Netflix, we would ask DNS for the IP address of Netflix. It would return the answer, and then our device would use that IP address to connect over the internet to the Netflix servers. So conceptually, the main piece of functionality which DNS provides is that it's a huge database which converts DNS names, so Netflix.com, into IP addresses. Now, so far, I hope that this makes sense. At this point, it sounds just like a database, so nothing complex. And you might be asking yourself, why not just have one DNS server globally or a small collection of servers? Now, we're going to review that in the next video. For this video, I just wanted to set the scene and make sure you understand exactly what functionality DNS provides. DNS is critical. Many large-scale failures on the internet are caused by either failed DNS or badly implemented DNS infrastructure. If you want to be effective at designing or implementing cloud solutions or network-based applications, you have to understand DNS. So if you are interested in knowing more, then go ahead and move to the next video where I'll cover why DNS is structured in the way that it is.